Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing another review for beautybigbang.com. Here is the cute pot that I'll be reviewing today. It consists of tons of round sequins and glitter confettis. The item code is J1329 and the color that I chose was in the number 3C. As always, I'll have the link for the product in the description box down below. This cute little pot consists of 3 to 4 different sizes of glitters, and there are various colors, the most prominent one being gold, and then there's some copper, some silver, some pink, and lastly some blue. I'll be showing what it looks like on this polish, which is a deep plum shade, and the second one would be this sheer pink polish. This is the Revlon Perfumery Powder Puff and it smells incredibly amazing. To give the glitter a tacky surface to stick to, I'll be applying a layer of top coat. And to pick the glitter, I'll be using the back of a scraper to put some top coat on, and then I'll be dipping the dotting tool into the top coat and using it to pick up the glitter. So let's start with the application. Firstly, I'll be applying a layer of the OPI top coat onto my nail. Make sure that the polish you use is not fast drying, because then it would defeat the purpose of using the top coat to get the glitter to stick to. I have already added a drop of the top coat on the back of the scraper, and then I've dipped the dotting tool into it, and then I'll be using it to pick up the glitters. Here I'm going to achieve the look of a gradient with these glitters. I do not have a particular pattern of colors to go with, because it's really assorted so deeply that you cannot pick up definite colors. And here it's like it's completely filled on the top and it is scattered more on the bottom. And here is the final look. It kind of looks like the glitter is sticking out, but one layer of top coat and a little bit of trimming would completely fix it. I've been seeing a lot of DIYs with pom-poms for earrings and necklaces, so I really think that it would look really cute with that. And here is what it looks like on the plum polish. To be honest, I like this much better, because this was the second time I did it, and so I made sure not to overlap the glitters so much and tried to keep it more uniform. That's all I have for you guys today. I'll leave everything in the description box down below. And if you like the video, give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel.